Like other widely distributed animals, the mulberry silkworms are reared in more than 30 countries of the world is differentiated into a number of genetically distinct races. Being a strictly domesticated and commercially exploited animal, each country is actively engaged in evolving new varieties or races of Bombyx mori by crossbreeding of native and exotic races. In Japan alone, for example, more than 2000 genetically identical races are maintained. In India, there are 200 races maintained in its different breeding center, and only a broad-based classification of breeds are attempted in this chapter. Earlier, the author and his colleagues had collected the data on the history of Japanese agriculture industry, the history of Japanese agriculture techniques before Meiji era, and the modern silkworm races which are now practically used in Japan. Silkworm Bombyx mori undergoes complete metamorphosis and passes through four distinct stages in their life cycle, namely egg, larva, pupa, and adult. The duration of each stage varies according to the race and according to the climatic conditions and the quality of food given. The duration of life cycle is spent in the egg stages varies depending upon whether it is hibernating or non-hibernating eggs. Hibernating eggs under natural conditions remain dormant for months together till the spring season in the next year. Diapause can be broken artificially by acid treatment. Non-hibernating eggs normally complete their embryonic development in 10 to 11 days and hatch out into larvae. The larvae emerges 3, 4 or 5 times and has 4, 5 or 6 larval instars. Most of the races are tetramolar and have 5 larval instar. The final instar larvae, after fully grown, stop feeding and spin a cocoon of silk around itself. The present study is intended to collect all the available details on the race and trace the lineage so as to make the present state serves as a source material for the improvement of silkworm breeds in future. The practical lineage of the races refers to this context actually means the lineage of silkworm breeds. The characteristics and the quality of these breeds from the practical point of view. This study also elucidates the interrelationship among the races. During the period when the concept of silkworm breed was not clearly defined, the term silkworm breed was not as restricted as it is now, but it was casually used to indicate the variety, type, or even the native place. According to the oldest literature available in Japan, such as the manuscripts on silkworm rearing method, the silkworm races of this period included Tsuchimayu, Kinkomayu, Kenmuki, Komoromayu, Siratoma, Komorowa, and Simaro. Tsuchimayu. The cocoons are fluffy, they are mostly irregular and multi-people. The cocoons are pale green or bamboo leaf colored or pale yellow colored. The cocoons are used for making cotton but are not suitable for reeling. Kinkomayu. It is used for preparing silk yarns and it is also suited for weaving. The silkworms produced barrel shaped cocoons of good grade. The cocoons are pure white. It includes type of ugumi which are large in size, kogumi which are smaller in size, and kayanari which are slightly elongated and spindle shaped. Kenmuki. The cocoons are yellow with binding knots. They are barrel shaped with a smooth surface and without tapering edges. They are considered as higher grade. Komoromayu. Cocoons are yellow or white without binding knots, are produced and the cocoons are of high grade and are suited for preparing yarn. Siratoma. Cocoons are shiny white. They are perfectly round in shape. They can be used for preparing raw silk, the fibers are slightly weak. Konamaro. Cocoons are short with binding knots. The cocoons are barrel shaped and whitish. Simaro. Cocoons are pale yellow color, but it is difficult to pick up the thread while reeling. It is not good for reeling. This variety was reared in large amount in Kanto region. It is also reared in Echu and the Kamigeta region. In these regions, the quality was considerably good. During the Meiji era, there was active and large-scale export of raw silk. Consequently, silviculture developed widely all over Japan. For this purpose, excellent silkworm varieties were chosen and efforts were made to prepare eggs for better quality. In many aspects, the silviculture industry was highly encouraged. The improvement of silkworm varieties related to the quality of silkworms, the quality of cocoon, and the quality of fiber. They were actively encouraged to make the export of raw silk and the production of cocoon more and more profitable. Omiko. It produced white cocoons. This type was characteristic for producing collective cocoons spun by several larvae. It was difficult to use the cocoons for producing silk fibers, and the cocoons were mostly used for producing silk cotton. However, the larvae were strong and resistant. Watakova. The larvae had dark markings. The body was pale or white in color, and the cocoons were light brown and irregular in shape. Cocoons were collectively produced by several larvae. The cocoons did not have a constant shape, and some were even angular. Some of the cocoons have deep constriction. Akusan. It is a bivoltine white cocoon producing with plain skinned larvae. The cocoons were medium in size and rich in silk fibers. The quality of cocoon fibers was good and suited for producing silk. However, Akusan was not very valuable during the Meiji era. Ikata. This variety was used for a very long period as one of the important types. It was easy to rear this variety, which was bivoltine and produced white cocoons. The cocoons are of different size. The larvae are somewhat strong. The quality of cocoon fibers, and it is used as silk producing varieties, does not show any major defects. Kaisanmaro. It is a bivoltine and the fiber quality of cocoon is low. The neatness defects were few, but the filament length was short. The cocoon yield is poor. The cocoons did not have a constant shape, and some were even angular. The quality of cocoon fibers and it is used till produced varieties does not show any major defects. Akajuku. It is a popular variety as a white cocoon producing type. It produced a large white cocoons. The cocoons were rich in fibers and the larvae were not very strong. The larvae were found to be weak and produced double cocoon. This type of race was valuable during the Meiji era. Kaisanmaro. Its important features such as strong and resistant larvae and good quality of cocoon fibers. It was produced too small, and at the same time, the reeling of the cocoons with deep constriction was also difficult. The larvae were found to be weak and produced double cocoon. Ogusa. It is a bivoltine white cocoon producing variety. It was popularly used during the Tempo period. Since the larvae are strong and the cocoons are large with good quality of cocoon filament, it remained widely popular even during the Meiji era. The larvae are strong and the cocoons are large. Kasuri. In Meiji era, it was used in name of the kasuri, which is univoltine variety. The multivoltine kasuri was easy to rear since the larvae are strong and the resistant. The cocoon yield is high as against the quality of mulberry leaf supply, and the thickness of the cocoon fiber was uniform. The cocoons are rich in fiber. Shihaku. The feature of this race or thickness of the cocoon fiber is inconsistent. The reeling is inferior to that of white cocoons. The quality cocoon fiber is lower than that of white cocoons, and the percentage of loss due to degumming is higher. The raw silk gets easily solid both on the front and on the back side. The appearance of the raw silk is not attractive. Kunichi. It is reared in large quantity of all over Japan. The cocoons have slightly tapering edges and do not have constriction. The larvae are strong and the reeling is good. The cocoons are rich in filament and the thickness of the cocoon fiber is slender and uniform. The fibers have a lower percentage of knitness defects and therefore the fibers are considered of excellent quality. Itonisiki. It was a univalent white cocoon producing varieties. The cocoons were thick and long. The cocoon shell was thick with a deep constriction. The cocoons had silver white luster. The size was medium. The fibers have a lower percentage of knitness defects and therefore the fibers are considered of excellent quality. Matahim. This variety was used for a very long period as one of the important types. It was easy to rear this variety, which was bivalten and produced white cocoons. The cocoons are different size. The larvae are somewhat strong. The quality of cocoon fibers and its use as silk producing varieties does not show any major defects. Kojuro. It is a bivalent and a white cocoon producing variety. It was popularly used during Tempo period. Since the larvae are strong and cocoons are large with good quality of silk filament, it remained widely popular even during the Meiji era. The larvae are strong and the cocoons are large. It is believed that the ancient silkworm races in Japan were the improved varieties derived from the original wild varieties. It is also evident that there has been much influence on this regard from the Chinese continent. This evidence is found in the information relating to the transport and communication. According to the ancient literature of China, Siamyagu, there were trimaltars and tetramaltars varieties of silkworm based on geographical distribution. The number of times the larvae molt and the silkworm in this literature were also classified into univalten, bivalten and multivalten depending upon how many times they complete their life cycle in a year. Variations in the designs of the body were also mentioned. Besides references, were also made to cocoon varieties such as single cocoon, double cocoon and multi-people cocoon on the one end and again silk reeling cocoons and fluffy cocoons on the other end. The silkworms of this continent have been directly used for reeling and Japan. Mainly these are classified into three types, namely number 1, geographical distribution. Japanese race. Fecundity rate is higher, ranging from 600 to 700 hex. Larvae are very active, healthy and robustness and leaf cocoon ratio is less. Egg is large, measuring about 1.30 mm into 1.01 mm, pale yellow color. Larval body size is small, normal, some have quill marking. Larval duration is longer, is around 26 days. The shape of the cocoon is triangulated and peanut. Almost all produced white color cocoons except a few are produced yellow or green colored cocoons. Further, percentage of double cocoon is more and quality of silk is better. Larvae are susceptible to grazery and flatchery. There are univalten and bivalten races in this group. Chinese race. In Chinese races, the fecundity rate is higher, ranging from 600 to 650 hex. The progress of the growth is quick, robust, and as a result of which, the leaf cocoon ratio is less. Egg is small, measuring about 1.29 mm into 1.07 mm, green in color. Most of the Chinese races are plain without any markings. The shape of the cocoon is round, elliptical, few of them are spindle shaped. The cocoon is white, golden yellow, flesh are red. The silk filament is fine and reliability is good. The Chinese races are resistant to high temperature and high humidity. Univalten, bivalten and multivalten races in this group and never trimaltars are noticed. European races. The fecundity rate is medium, ranging from 550 to 600 eggs and size of the eggs is large, measuring about 1.43 mm into 1.18 mm. The larval stage is long. The molting period is reduced by 1 to 2 hours. The larvae are large, plain, without any markings. The cocoons are big, long, elliptical. Cocoons are either white or flesh colored. The percentage of double cocoons is less. The silk filament length is long with good reliability. European races are weak against high temperature and high humidity. All are univoltine. Southeast Asian races. Fecundity rate is lower, ranging from 400 to 500 hex. Hex are small. The larval length is short with few exceptions where the tropical races of India exhibited longer larval duration. The larval markings are not common in these races. Leaf cocoon ratio is high. The size of the larvae is small. The shape of the cocoon is spindle, flashy with less filament length. The common cocoon color is green, yellow, white. Denier of the silk filament is fine. These races are resistant to varied environmental conditions, especially in high temperature and high humidity. Multivoltine races are very common in this group. Indian races. Fecundity rate is lower, ranging from 400 to 500 x. X are small, measuring about 0.6 mm into 0.5 mm, oval shape and light yellow grayish in color. Larvae are healthy, robust, and the size of the larvae is small. Larval duration is longer and larval marking is present. Leaf cocoon ratio is high. The shape of the cocoon is spindle, oval, flashy with medium silk filament length. The cocoon color is yellow, white, golden yellow and green in color. Multivoltine, bivoltine and univoltine races are common in this group. Voltinism is a term used in biology to indicate the number of generation of an organism in a year and a natural environmental condition is called as voltinism. Based on voltinism, Silkworm bombyx mori hell is divided into a three types, namely univoltine race. They produce only one generation in a year. The larval weight is comparatively higher and cocoons are heavy. Denier of the silk filament is about 2.3. They are not suitable for summer and winter season, since the larvae are weak against unfavorable conditions, especially to higher temperature. They lay only diapausing eggs. All European races are univoltine. Example, Borapalo, bivoltine race. They produce two generations in a year. The length of the larval period is short. The leaf cocoon ratio is less and the quality of the cocoons are inferior to that of univoltine races. Further, cocoon weight, shell weight, silk percentage and filament length is lesser than univoltine race. Most of the temperature races are bivoltine and less both non-hibernating and hibernating hex. Example, NB4D2, NB18, NB7, KA, etc. Tetravoltine race. They produce four generations in a year. The length of the larval period is short. The cocoons are of moderate size but somewhat elongated. The larvae are healthy and easy to rear. The silk filament quality is also good and it was widely used for rearing. Multivoltine race. They produce more than 5 to 6 generations in a year. The length of the larval duration is short. In most of the polyvoltine races, the leaf cocoon ratio is high. Cocoons are compact grained and cocoon's layer is soft. The length of the silk filament is short. However, the silk filament is fine and clean with little lusiness, but with more lustrous. The larvae are robust and can tolerate fluctuating environmental conditions and hence the best suited for tropical climatic conditions. They lay only non-diapausing eggs. Examples, Pure Mysore, Osa Mysore, Sinichi. Moltenism. Molting or egg dices is the manner in which an animal routinely casts off an outer layer with the help of molting hormones in its life cycle is called moltenism. Silkworm can be classified into tri, tetra and pentamolters. Trimolters. This group includes silkworms which undergo three times molting during their larval period are called trimolters. That larval growth is limited. The larval duration is short, ranging from 15 to 18 days. Pupae and mass are small. Cocoon weight is less. Cocoon filament is fine. And denier of the silk filament ranges from 1.6 to 1.7. Tetramoltars. This group includes silkworm which undergoes 4 times molting during their larval period are called tetramoltars. The length of the larval period is medium, ranging from 24 to 28 days. The larval growth and cocoon weight is medium. Denier is 2 to 2.5. Tetramoltars are cosmopolitan in their distribution. Pentamoltars. This group includes silkworms which undergoes 5 times molting in their larval period are called pentamoltars. The length of the larval period is long, larval weight is high, and cocoons are heavy. Filament length is more, denier of the silk filament is high.